7. This is News at 6.
ABC 7 is staying on top of a brush fire that started yesterday in Golden Gate Estates and sparked again today. It's your big story right now at 6. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Megan Miller. The fire has been threatening homes and did some damage to vehicles and other property outside. Tonight, ABC 7's Alexa Velez is talking to neighbors who watched the flames flare back up today.
And while we were out here speaking with neighbors about yesterday's fire, it actually started up again at this house here behind me. If you look to the left, you can see the flames and there's little embers flying everywhere. The smoke is very heavy in the area. Crews are making their way out right now to extinguish it before it does get worse.
Unfortunately, it's back again, you know. We saw some hot spots yet, and they worked diligently till about midnight, and maybe even longer than that.
Flames reignited today in Golden Gate Estates in a bush near homes along 6th Avenue Northeast and Everglades Boulevard. The sheriff's office helicopter dropped buckets of water on this area less than 24 hours ago to put out the original fire that forced people to evacuate.
Helicopter and emergency fire services were definitely in high gear and making sure that it seemed to me that everything was put out pretty quick.
Crews from North Collier Fire Rescue and Greater Naples Fire worked on the ground to protect homes. Unfortunately, two airboats, a car, ATV, and shed were damaged.
Yes, with wind shifts and other things occurring, yes, embers do fly, spot fires occur. However, at the current time, all the fire is contained within the line.
Mop-up efforts now for the second day in a row already underway. Crews are working diligently to make sure this fire doesn't spark again. Reporting in Golden Gate Estates, I'm Alexa Velez, ABC 7.
And it hasn't been easy battling this brush fire. It's dry season, and we want to get you more on the conditions crews are dealing with out there. Chief Meteorologist John Patrick joins us now with a look at how the weather is impacting this fire.
And it's the wind that's impacting it the most. You can see right now our live reading out of Naples at Lorenzo Walker Technical High School, 13 miles an hour. And the wind goes up and down occasionally, but the gust has been up to near 30 miles per hour this afternoon. And we're going to see these gusty winds continue on into the evening. And that's why there's a wind advisory. Coincidentally, not for Collier, but for everybody else, through 8 o'clock as we go through the day on Thursday. 20 to 30 mile an hour sustained winds and gusts to 40. We could see some tree limbs and objects, light objects being blown around and that kind of thing tomorrow as we get between 30 and 40 mile an hour wind gust. And the other thing is, there's no rain out there. Here's Collier County. You can see the radar sweep is dry, and that's not helping firefighter efforts at all. You can see the rest of the region is dry as well. So no rain coming in this evening other than maybe an isolated sprinkle along the sea breeze boundary. As we go through the day tomorrow, as you saw, wind advisories in effect. Those gusts in the afternoon approaching 30 or more miles per hour. They're going to be out of the south. But look what happens up here. There's a line and then the wind arrows kind of bend. That's our next cold front. And if you stick around, I'm going to track the rain and the drop in humidity and heat after that little line passes through with your most accurate forecast.
A man is in the